Good morning everyone. Dear students, today I am discussing another concept, that is division ring or skew field. So before going to discuss division ring, all of you know that integral domain. So integral domain means it should satisfy the condition commutative ring with unity and ring without zero divisor. So all of you know that zero divisor means for all a comma b belongs to R, then a not equal to 0 and b not equal to 0, where a into b equal to 0. That is zero divisor. Ring with zero divisor means same condition. Ring without zero divisor means at least one of them should be 0. That is either a equal to 0 or b equal to 0, then a into b equal to 0. That is ring without zero divisor. So now let us discuss the definition of division ring or skew field. So, definition of division ring is, a ring R is said to be division ring if R have unit element and second one R have multiplicative inverse for each non-zero element of R. Otherwise, we can also define like this, a set R is said to be division ring if R plus is an abelian group. That means it should satisfy closure law, associative law, identity law, inverse law and commutative law. Right. So, if we satisfy all these conditions, then that is known as abelian group under addition. So, next R dot is a group. Here we have to satisfy closure law, associative law, identity law and inverse law. Here we are solving only four conditions under multiplication, then it should be a group. If it satisfies all the above four conditions, then it should be a group. So R dot is a group, second condition. And third condition is R plus dot satisfies distributive laws. Under addition and multiplication, it should satisfy distributive law, that is A dot B plus C equal to A into B plus A into C. And second one, A plus B dot C gives A dot C plus B dot C. So this is our division ring concept. For example, the set of all n cross n non-singular matrices over real numbers is a division ring with respect to addition and multiplication. Because in matrix addition, these all conditions holds good, and in matrix multiplication, these all condition holds good. That's why it is a division ring or a skew field. Got it? Next, I am discussing field. Here, field definition contains a commutative division ring. A commutative division ring is called a field. That means, so commutative law holds good under multiplication, then it is known as field. Okay. If it does not satisfy, then it is not a ring. Sorry, field. So let us consider one note. The above example is not a field because it does not satisfy the matrix multiplication. In matrix multiplication is not commutative because it is not a field. Gotaita? Matrix multiplication alli commutative law exist agudilla, that's why it is not a field. Got it? The above example is not a field because matrix multiplication is not commutative. So this is the definition of division ring and field. Let us consider relation between integral domain and field. Take one theorem. So this theorem is most important for your examination, that is every field is an integral domain, but the converse is not true. That means every field is an integral domain, but converse is not true. Field enagutta, integral domain agutta, but integral domain enagudilla, field agudilla anta helidangartha. Okay. Every field is an integral domain, but the converse is not true. Understand the theorem statement. So let us recall the definition of field and integral domain. So field means it should satisfy the commutative division ring. Commutative division ring means So R plus is an abelian group, R dot is a group, and R plus dot satisfies distribution law, that is division ring. So here commutative law holds good under multiplication, then that is known as field. Okay, so integral domain means, what do you mean by integral domain? It is a ring with commutative ring with unity and ring without zero divisor, then that is known as integral domain. Okay, let us solve the condition. Take down proof. Consider, let F be a field. F andre in consider manatini, field anta consider manakatini. Then by definition F is a commutative ring with unity. Commutative ring with unity in which multiplicative inverse of every non-zero element of F exists. So then by definition F is a commutative ring with unity in which multiplicative inverse of every non-zero element of F exists. For example, 2 belongs to Z, 1 by 2 also belongs to Z. That means 2 the inverse 1 by 2 agatala, a condition satisfy in field olaga. Other answer in barbek, 1 barbek. That is known as commutative ring with unity. Next, to prove F is without zero divisors. Okay, so now I am considering, let A comma B belongs to F such that A is not equal to 0 and A into B equal to 0. Any one of them, we have to show that it is not equal to 0. Either A equal to 0 or B equal to 0, then A into B equal to 0. So here I am considering A is not equal to 0 and A into B equal to 0. Then it can be written as A is not equal to 0 means A belongs to F. If A belongs to F, then multiplicative inverse is also belongs to F by above statement, because every non-zero element is invertible in F, that is field. Okay, now consider this as A inverse belongs to F, then A into B also belongs to 0. A inverse belongs to F, A into B belongs to 0. So this can be written as A inverse into, the multiply matter, A inverse into A into B equal to A inverse into 0. So now I am considering A into B can multiply madagatini, A inverse multiply madagatini. So A inverse into 0. So this can be written as, what I have to show that here, B equal to 0, A not equal to 0, compulsory B equal to 0 on the torusbek. So that can be written as A inverse into A, B outside togori. So A inverse into 0 is again 0. So this implies A inverse into A, that is E. That can be written as A into 1 by A, the result is 1. 1 should be taken as E. Got it? So E into B equal to 0. So B into 1 equal to B, because here 1 should be considered as E, that is identity element. So this gives B equal to 0, which is without zero divisor. Therefore F is without zero divisors. therefore consequently f is an integral domain, got it? So converse part of the theorem gives, conversely f is an integral domain, integral domain. What we have to show that here the converse is not necessarily true because every integral domain is not a field. See, the converse is not necessarily true because every integral domain is not a field. So let us take one example. I am considering z plus dot is an integral domain. Obviously, it should satisfy all the conditions. It should satisfy the condition of commutative ring with unity and ring without zero divisors. That is why it is a integral domain. But it is not a field. Why? Because its non-zero elements, except 1 and minus 1 do not have their multiplicative inverse in Z. That means if 2 belongs to Z, then 1 by 2 does not belong to Z because it is rational number. It does not contain set of integers. That's why 2 belongs to Z and 1 by 2 does not belong to Z. It is in multiplicative inverse. Multiplication olaga neeva 2 the inverse enanta gothiri 1 by 2 anta gothiri. This is in multiplication. But in addition naam enta gothivi 2 the inverse minus 2. This is in addition and this is in multiplication. Because its result gives 1 and its result gives 0. 2 minus 2 is 0 and 2 into 1 by 2 the result gives 1. So that's why it is not a multiplicative inverse. So z is not a field. Z plus dot is not a field. Got it? So next consider another definition, that is finite ring. So what do you mean by finite ring? A ring containing finite number of elements, then it is known as finite ring. So for example, Z6 is a finite ring. Got it? So next definition is infinite ring. So what do you mean by infinite ring? A ring containing infinite number of elements, then it is called infinite ring. See here, a ring containing infinite number of elements, then it is called infinite ring. Got it? So next definition is invertible. So what do you mean by invertible? So invertible means which is in the form of inverse. Got it? So here, let R be a ring with identity E is an element, then A belongs to R is said to be left invertible A belongs to R is said to be left invertible if there exist B belongs to R such that A into B equal to E, where B is right invertible. Where B is right invertible. Got it? Here I am considering one ring with unity with identity element E, and A belongs to R, that is said to be left invertible, and if there exists B belongs to R such that A into B be equal to E. So here it is known as left invertible, and the B is known as right invertible. If the left and right invertible gives the product as identity, that is E. Got it? So here consider another one. Here I am considering A as left invertible. Now I am considering A as right invertible. That can be written as if A is A to B, A is said to be right invertible, right invertible, if there exist C belongs to R such that C into A equal to E, C into A equal to E, where C is left invertible. See here. So now I am considering C as left invertible and A as right invertible, because here A satisfies both the conditions, that is left invertible and right invertible. Therefore A belongs to R is known as invertible or regular or unit. That implies if A belongs to R is both left invertible and right invertible, then we say that A is invertible. Got it? If it satisfies both right invertible and left invertible, then it is known as invertible or regular or unit. So this is the concept of invertible. Okay, next consider one theorem, that is if A is a unit or invertible or inverse or regular, these all are known as invertible conditions. Okay, if A is unit, then its left and right inverse are same. How to prove that A is a invertible? So its both left and right inverse are same. So let us take down proof. Let A be a unit, then A into B equal to E is left invertible. How the next right invertible can hear the definition? C into A equal to E, that is right invertible. How the So that means B equal to 1 by A and C equal to 1 by A. Thiradangartha. A into 1 by A idra adra value en bartati, identity element bartati. Here B is nothing but 1 by A and C is also nothing but 1 by A. Its result gives identity element anta heladanga. So it's now it gives B can be written as E into B. Bari boda nana. B equal to E into B, that is nothing but 1 into B. Hoda? So ille E iddalle nana en substitution markotini, C into A na substitution markotini, C into A into B. Hoda? So ivaga C na outside idri, A into B na inside tagori. So again A into B gives the value E, that is left invertible. So this is E. C into E gives C. C into identity element is what? C. Got it? So B equal to C. Thus, if A belongs to R, is a unit, then its left and right invertible or inverse, left and right invertible of the same element are same, of the same element, which is denoted by A inverse. Got it? So this is our theorem. If A is a unit, then its left and right inverse are same. So this is our condition. AB unit and consider madakthini, other by definition of left invertible and right invertible, I am taking A into B equal to E and C into A equal to E. So now again I am considering B equal to E into B. That is in the form of 1 into B. Now substitute E as right invertible, that is C into A. Substitution madri into B as it is. C na as it is, idri A into B, A na outside somebody, that is A into B. ಅವೆರಡು ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊರಿ. ಎ ಇಂಟು ಬಿ ಗ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡ್ರಿ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಬಲ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ನೋನ್ ಆಸ್ ಇ. ಅಗೇನ್ ಸಿ ಇಂಟು ಇ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ ಸಿ. ಗಾಟ್ ಇಟ್? ಸೊ ನಾವು ಬಿ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಸಿ, ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರೈಟ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸೇಮ್, ಆರ್ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರೈಟ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಬಲ್ ಆರ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿನೋಟೆಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಅವರ್ ಥೇರಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್. Prove that if A comma B belongs to R, then A plus B whole square equal to A square plus AB plus BA plus B square, where X square means X into X. So that means A square can be written in the form of A into A. So let us take the solution for this condition. All of you know that A plus B whole square. So A plus B whole square can be written as split madri A plus B into A plus B. So next multiply madri, that is right distribution law, that is A into A plus B plus B into A plus B, which is right distributive law. Hoda? So next enanta time multiply madri A into A plus A into B plus B into A plus B into B. That is left distributive law. Right. So A into A can be written as A square. That is, they had given X dot X gives X square. So A square plus AB plus BA plus B square. They may ask it for 2 marks. Next, the second problem is, so what they are giving, if A square equal to R, sorry, A square equal to A for all A belongs to R, then A plus A equal to 0. So see here, A square equal to A. So here they had given A plus A equal to 0. So I am considering it as A plus A whole square equal to A plus A. So it can be written as A plus A into A plus A equal to A plus A. So next multiply madri A into A A square plus A into A A square plus A into A A square plus A into A A square into A plus A, because A square equal to A. ಆ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾ ಏನ್ ತಗೊಂಡಿನಿ, ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿನಿ. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ A square is A plus A plus A plus A. This is equal to A plus A. So ಇವಾಗ ಒನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ ನ ಈ ಸೈಡ್ ತಗೊಂಬರ್ರಿ, ಅವಾಗ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಮೈನಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತ A plus A equal to A plus A minus A plus A equal to 0. A plus A equal to 0 by cancellation law. ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲೇಷನ್ ಲಾ. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು, ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಐತಲ್ರಿ ಎ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಎ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಎ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಎ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದಲ್ರಿ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಕೋಬೇಡ್ರಿ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನನಗೆ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ ಝೀರೋ ಬೇಕು, ಒನ್ ಅಲ್ಲ. ಎ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಎ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಎ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಎ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ ಒನ್, ಸೊ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಝೀರೋ. ಸೊ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋರಿ ಟರ್ಮ್ನ, ಎ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಎ ಇಂಟು ಎ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಎ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಎ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಎ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್. ಸೊ ಎ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎ ಅಂತ ಐತಿ, ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋರಿ. ಮತ್ತೆ ಅಷ್ಟು ಆಡ್ ಮಾಡಿರಿ, ಆಡ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಡ್ರಿ. ಎರಡೇ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ನ ಕಂಬೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋರಿ. ಕಂಬೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಾಗ ಒಂದು ಟರ್ಮ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ದಟ್ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ ಝೀರೋ, ಎ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಎ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ ಝೀರೋ. So this is another example from this condition. So if every x belongs to R satisfies x square equal to x, then prove that R must be commutative. So here I am considering, take down solution, a plus b whole square equal to a plus b, because a square equal to a, otherwise x square equal to x. So I am considering x as a plus b whole square equal to a plus b. So split madri from first condition, a square plus ab plus ba plus b square equal to a plus b. So now substitute the value, a square as a plus ab plus ba plus b square equal to a plus b, sorry, here b square as b, because x square equal to x. Next, a plus b na outside tagiri, plus evaldo terms na one kade maadkori, ab, ab plus ba, ab plus ba, this is equal to a plus b. Here a plus b, a plus b get cancelled, so ab plus ba equal to 0. A b plus b a equal to 0. So this can be written as a b plus b a equal to a into b plus b, because b plus b equal to 0. B plus b equal to 0 from this condition. B plus b equal to 0. Then this gives AB plus BA equal to AB plus BA. So AB, AB get cancelled. BA equal to AB. Because therefore R is commutative. Got it? Like this type we will solve example based on axioms. So in next class I will discuss subrings. Thank you.